Democrat donors, well, they want NBA legends to run for office. Let's put it up full mass. Okay. Let's talk about this plan. Florida Democrats have put former NBA legends Dwyane Wade and Grant Hill at the top of their wish list as they look for a strong candidate to run against Senator Rick Scott in the 2024 election. I think both of these gentlemen are actually stellar individuals, all right? I really do. They're human like anyone else. Good people. There have been strong efforts led by Democratic donors to get both men to consider stepping into politics. But three sources familiar with the effort say the push hasn't been from the state or national parties, according to NBC News. Some donors feel recruiting a candidate who is popular throughout the state and has the ability to self-fund their own campaign could reset the political narrative. Now, where is this likely coming from? Okay, so this is Florida, right? This is the Democratic side of Florida. So they're looking at their neighbor, Georgia. They always look at Georgia. And in Georgia, Herschel Damn Walker almost became a US senator. And let's be frank, I mean, the guy won, I'm talking about Senator Warnock, won by less than 1%. Herschel Walker slaughtered every single Republican in the Republican primary, including Republicans who were already elected statewide, had already won Republican primaries statewide. He beat them too. He did not go to one debate in the Republican primary, not one. And so you see, if he would have at least not told that vampire and werewolf story, he may be a US senator today. So Florida Democrats are saying, well, maybe we can apply some of that strategy here. Now, let me just say this. I am not comparing these gentlemen to Herschel Walker. All right, there is nobody I can think of in my mind that I can actually compare to Herschel Walker. All right, Grant Hill has great name ID. He would raise a boatload of money and is one of the smartest guys you ever meet, said John Morgan to NBC News, an Orlando-based trial attorney and national Democratic donor who has spoken directly with Hill about his desire for him to run. Grant Hill will beat the ish out of Rick Scott. All right, Grant Hill, brother, don't eat that rib sandwich. That man has no idea if you'll beat Rick Scott or not, okay? Don't eat that rib sandwich. If you run for something, you run for something based on your decision, your research, and your people doing the fact checks. Don't eat that rib sandwich, okay? Obviously, I'm much more concerned with your politics as it relates to policy. Now, I know where you stand on some things because I see what you support and the values that you exude, and I think they're good. But to be in this position, having a defined political policy personality is required, not because you may get co-opted by Republicans, we know that won't happen, but because you may get co-opted by mainstream Democrats who tell you, you can't help those folks. It's not the right time to support this bill. No, you can't say that on TV. I don't want you to be that person. So definitely, I want to know your politics if you choose to run, and that goes for anybody, all right? Hill played 7 seasons with the Orlando Magic and reportedly still lives in Orlando. He campaigned with Hillary Clinton in 2016 in Jacksonville and has criticized President Donald Trump over disrespectful comments he made about the city of Baltimore. Hill hasn't shown political aspirations in the past. The party also targeted Dwyane Wade as a prime candidate. The former NBA star spent 13 seasons with the Miami Heat, but recently opened up about moving his family out of the state because Florida Republicans filed more than 15 anti-trans bills alone during the 2023 legislative session. Wade has a 15-year-old transgender daughter. Top donors and party leaders know they need different kinds of candidates with pre-existing profiles to mount statewide campaigns, said a veteran Florida Democratic operative who was granted anonymity to discuss candidate recruiting strategy with NBC. There's a short list of retired athletes and business leaders who could fit that bill, and Dwyane Wade tops that list. There are definitely conversations underway about recruiting Wade or a retired athlete like him to challenge Scott. All right, here we go. They're not recruiting you because of your political prowess. They're not recruiting you because of your policy stance, nor because of your existing political capital or popularity. They are recruiting you because you played a sport and good at it. Remember that. I don't mind you walking that into the door, but make sure if you do, you're standing up for the least of these in every meeting that you attend. You see, you have the opportunity to be different because you got something they would never have. And that's popularity entering into the political mainframe. You can use that. You can use it. All right. So I don't know what's going to happen here. It will be interesting to see. I was engaged in conversations like this when I was head of the State Democratic Party for Georgia. I remember a day, dear brother, when Senator Warnock, who was just Reverend Warnock at that time, he walked into my office. This was years before he ran for Senate. He talked about wanting to run for Senator one day. We had a great conversation, stayed in my office for about an hour. So I knew he wanted to do this. When the time was right, our dear brother ran for office and he won. He's a US Senator this very moment, right? So sometimes the conversation starts and it's a cycle or two before the actual race happens. Thoughts?
I mean, just today, we've had a story about a former reality TV star becoming president, a former college football player, a politician. So it is in a very easy realm of possibility for Grant Hill to run for public office one day in Orlando or in Florida. And I want to say, I'm a huge fan of Grant Hill. I can remember the Grant Hill drink Sprite commercial. I wore his Fila's in grade school. I wanted to play piano like him because he played. But like you said, if he's not going to support the least of these as part of policy, if he were to run, he better not step anywhere near a poll or at any point near Florida. But yep. I guess we'll see, because it is very much in the realm of possibility here in America.
Definitely. And I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying I want it to be a good thing. That's all.